Unlike other wilderness sites where you might encounter a food cache or a pole for hanging your food, Gwaii Haanas is a truly wilderness experience where you're gonna be in a remote setting and you're gonna have to be self-sufficient and able to hang your own food. So you need to come prepared with the equipment to do that and the capability to do that yourself. There's a rule of thumb that you try to get your food off the ground at ideally 5 meters and away from the stem of the trunk about 1.5 meters. And so what you're doing is you're ensuring that an animal on the ground is unable to access it, as well as any animal that might climb up that trunk of the tree. So what we recommend to people is that you don't store your food in your kayak, obviously because it is accessible to animals and we don't want animals being habituated to human food, but also obviously we don't want your equipment being damaged by an animal trying to access that. So you need to think about it from both the perspective of the traveler, but also the animal.
And then this tree is too skinny, this one.
So if this is a new technique for you, certainly a good idea to practice at home. You want to come prepared with an adequate line that's going to be long enough and light enough. You can get it up over a branch of a tree, and you need some weight at the end of that so you can throw the line up adequately. A piece of driftwood is fine, but if some people prefer to bring along something that they're more comfortable throwing so that they're able to get it over a tree limb.
Nice!
The bag that you're going to store your food in, is it adequate? Do you want to have your food stored in a waterproof bag, ideally? And then if you're traveling in a large group, you may need to break that food up into several different bags to make it possible to get it off of the ground. You're going to need to work together as a team, potentially, to hang your food, and certainly while you're tying it off, have somebody's help in taking the weight off that bag or taking the load while somebody else does the tying off of the line to secure it in the air. It's a good idea to think about this before you actually go to hang your food, but identifying some limb down on the ground or a down tree or fallen tree that is heavy enough and secure enough that you can tie it off to that. We don't want people hanging their food right above their campsites. Choose a site that's a reasonable distance away from your site so that you're not attracting the wildlife to your actual campsite. If you're new to hanging food in a wilderness setting, this is something that's a good idea to try at home. We recommend as best practice that you hang anything that's going to be potentially an attractant to an animal. So obviously your food for sure, but any other items that have been exposed to food, so your pots and pans, your cooking equipment for sure, scented items like toiletries, as well as certainly any garbage that you're going to obviously be packing out with you needs to be hung up in there. They all can possibly be attractants, and we really, you know, want to be protecting the wildlife that exists in Gwaii Haanas. And something that's important to consider, we want to promote that people hang their food at night, but if you're going to leave your campsite to, say, go for a hike or something like that, we want to make sure that at that time you're also hanging your food to make sure that basically whenever your food or food items are unattended, that they're in that secured spot. We want to have people hanging their food, obviously for bears. That's what people think of first and foremost when they think of hanging their food. But we want to keep your food and food products away from any animals that could be attracted to it. So that includes birds for sure, which can be very curious and interested in food that's left laying around. Rodents, raccoons, basically all the different wildlife that you're going to encounter in the terrestrial environment could potentially be interested in the food that you've left out. Yeah, well, what we really want to resonate with visitors to Gwaii Haanas is that by hanging your food properly and securely and safely, you're ensuring that you're going to have an enjoyable trip, but you're also ensuring that you're protecting the wildlife of Gwaii Haanas.